essentials. And honestly, I think we should just get right into it. First thing I got, most important thing, my Bible. I guess this is just a symbol too for God, religion, my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The Bible, this is my number one essential. This is one of my Bibles. I use different Bibles for different things. Sometimes I use my phone Bible. But this is my main, like, just next thing. Let's do these. This is kind of sad, but this is probably my third most important essential to like my personality. And it is my colognes. I have four colognes here with me that I chose for this video for various reasons. The first one I chose is YSYDB, because this is kind of just like my dumb reach, like signature. I know it'll always get compliments. People will always like it, especially like in a school environment. This is great, like sweet, fresh, youthful, green apple, a little bit of woodiness, a little aquatic, very sharp. There's a clone of this called Ladafa Fakar Black that is a better buy than this. I would just get that instead. Also, yesterday, I was supposed to get, well, I guess now it's today. Currently, at the time of recording this, it is, Friday the 13th of September, excuse me, Friday the 13th of September. This is getting uploaded on Saturday the 14th. But currently, I was supposed to receive a package today with a bunch of, like, clones that I blind bought, but it didn't come. So I'm hoping that it comes on the 14th, which is Saturday, which is when this video is being uploaded. And as soon as that comes, I'm making a video on my other channel, Ben's Fragrances, linked in the description. So go check that out if you're interested in like colognes and stuff. But yeah, that was the first one I got, YSYDB. Next one I got is one of my favorite smelling colognes, is Ladafa Cambra. I love this. This is like an inspired by Angel Share. I mean, if you just look at the bottle, like, it looks like Angel Share. But this is, like, it smells totally different. Angel Share is much more, like, woody. So, yeah. This stuff smells really good. I can't smell it all right now. I smell tiny bit after my surgery. It's really hard for me to smell in the morning and at night for whatever reason. But, yeah. Really good stuff, like cinnamon, apple, nutmeg, spices, a little bit of fruitiness, a lot of vanilla, like apple pie almost. It's really good stuff. Smells like Christmas in a bottle almost, really. This is the best winter cologne ever, especially for the price line, like $35-$40. Projection longevity is pretty good too. It'll last you pretty much all day if you spray enough times, like 7 or 8 sprays, maybe like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or something like that. I don't know. Maybe some under the shirt, maybe some on the pants, depending on your spray routine, maybe some on the wrist. That's probably what I would do though. Can't wait until it gets cooler and I can wear this. Wearing that as soon as it drops below 60. As soon as the high is below 60, I'm wearing that. I'm so excited. It looks super cool without the cap too, honestly. And the juice is cool. I'm gonna spray it right now. I don't even know if I can smell it. Oh, I can smell it. Going out cologne. It's fresh. Everyone loves it. I get compliments on it pretty such a good cologne, and the people around me are just really nice. But yeah, this is super fresh, like lavender, bergamot, aquatic, then some musks, a little bit of woodiness. But yeah, this is great, and it lasts like 8-10 hours. 75 ml, and it has, let me see if I can see how much is left. No, I can't. I'm trying to use like the ring light to see how much is left, but it's not really working, never mind. But yeah, this stuff is really good. It's like kind of like ceramic or whatever. This is really good. Nope, I can smell. It's a Abercrombie Fitch Fierce kind of DNA, Mount Blanc Legend. Awesome, man. This little few sneakers because I'm a little bit of a sneakerhead. I'm not nearly as much of a sneakerhead as I was, but. And then I used to have a YouTube channel with my friend, and I'm not going to disclose the name of that channel, but I was in like 6th grade or something, and we would just make stupid videos on like the phone and stuff. It was great, man. It was great. What else did I have? I had another channel that was just the most random stuff ever when I was like early middle school, late elementary. Oh, and I had a Fortnite gaming channel, and, like, I made Fortnite montages all the time. I was good at Fortnite, I was really good, so I made montages. Then I played Fall Guys for a little bit. I had a Minecraft channel for a little bit. Man, I've always been making videos, but I love it. So, yeah. And all the shows I quit because I never, like, got successful, but this one, I don't really ever see myself quitting. Well, actually, I graduate in a little while. Just get less consistent. I don't know. Let's not talk about quitting because, yeah, content creation is my next essential. Next thing I have, this one's gonna be a short one, is water. Water. Like, I quite literally need this to live. So, this is one of my water. I have two main, like, water, like, drinking things that my Stanley that my girlfriend got me. She got it for me. I did not buy myself. And this is good for, like, at home and stuff. And then I have something called an Awala for, like, when I go places. Because it's, like, good. I don't know how to explain it. Like, it's a water bottle, and it's, like, really awesome. It's, like, closes, but it has a straw and stuff. And it's, like, insulated. It's just really light. There's a 40 ml. I mean, not ml. Ounces. 40 ounces. And my Awala is a 32, but I want to get a 40.
Huge mark right here. This is
expensive, so I learned that if I just kind of stopped involving myself in, like, sneakerhead culture, I would stop buying them, which is the right financial decision. But yeah, these are, like, my favorite shoes because they, like, are iconic, obviously, and they match my school colors, so I can wear them. And then I have two other shoes that I, yeah, style is also really important to me. Style, these are my Peter, like, Air Force Ones. Style, just, like, how I dress, I like dressing nice, I don't know. To say that, like, I used to be, like, the highlighter Nike, like, gym shorts and gym shirt kid in middle school, but it's fine. Now I like dressing, like, nicer. I don't know, like, I like dressing, like, old money, I guess. Like, I'd rather wear a polo than a t-shirt, if that makes sense. Or, like, a button-down, or I like Hawaiian shirts a lot, too. I guess that's not really old money, because it's kind of graphic. I just have my own style. It's a mix of a lot of things. But yeah. And then the last shoe I have is a Jordan 4, which I also love wearing because it goes with, like, everything, and it's kind of bulky, and it's, like, sneaker-ready. Because, like, an Air Force 1, like, anyone wears Air Force 1s, but if you wear Jordan 4, it's, like, you know about sneakers. But yeah, and then, like, basketball. I love basketball. It's the only sport I play. I wouldn't play, like, volleyball if my school had a team. But yeah, I play point guard, starting point guard for my varsity team. And my highest scoring game is 31. I hit like 7 threes, or 8, 7 or 8 threes that game. It was ridiculous. So yeah. Which, 31's really good for a high school game, I think. I went ballistic. Basketball.